Hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to construct an activity diagram for library management system. So I'm going to do this entire task in star UML. So let's get started. So first just go to model and go to add diagram, and we are going to select activity diagram. So once we click it, all our necessary shapes to construct our activity diagram will be loaded. So first thing, for whatever may be the online system we are going to do, the first thing it's going to be login and register. So for activity diagram, we need to start from initial. Okay, just proceed and press over here. So we got our initial one, and next is our action. So first action is going to be login. Okay, login and register. So login. So login are those for those who are like a repeated user, or they are coming for the second time. So initially, like, everyone needs to register first. So if it's a new user, we need to redirect him to the register and then to the login. So for that, we need to have a decision box. Okay, this diamond shaped one, just have a decision box, and let's just have a text over here. Okay, a text. So let's just say new user. Okay, so new user, we just over here. So if it's a new user, and let's have another text. Yes. Okay, so if it's a new user, we need to I will just put an arrow, okay, after placing all the action boxes. So if it's a new user, we need to make him to register. So register is going to come here, G-I-S-T-E-R. okay, so register. And let's also add another text over here. So no, so if he's not an new user, so we can just allow him to go to the validation part. So validation part is authentication or validation. So here we'll be just checking whether the user has entered the right mail ID and a corresponding right password to that mail ID. So just an authentication. So it's let's just put an action box and type authentication. Okay, authentication, it's fine. And after authentication, let's just put another decision box. So this one is just to check whether the user has entered the right stuff or not. So for that, we will put a text. Okay, check. So after just another few moments, I've just connected with the arrows, then you can get a whole idea what I'm doing over here. So if it's valid, means let's here we are going to have like two text. Okay, so valid. So valid means the user will be allowed to go to the official website or something, official portal where he can just go and get the books for the library system. And suppose if he enters an invalid password or email ID, so he'll be again redirected to login itself. So, okay, so invalid. So that's it. So now just put all the arrows. For arrows, you can go with control flow. Okay, so from login, from start to login, and from login to this decision box. And then if he's a new user, means from new user to register, and after the new user registers, he can just go and again login. Okay, so what if he isn't a new user, that is new user is no, you can just go and go to the authentication, and after authentication he will be checked, his authentication will be checked, his mail and password. Okay, this is too much slanting. You can just move this and make it, you can even change the size and make it straight, so that looks good. And authentication, and suppose if he enters something invalid, here to again go to the login. So you can just have like this. If you place like this, it will just overlap, so you can just select this line and you can just move it like this over here. You can make it as a rectangle shape, so that's fine. So if he enters something invalid, he will be again redirected to the login itself. So, and if he enters the valid terms, he can just go to the next part. So next part will divide into multiple things. As you can know, we are going to have a library system. So the user can, we don't know what the user is going to do. So the user can go and check for a book. The user can go to check the due date. He or else can go and pay the fine or penalty. He or she can go and check whether the book is particular, book is available or not. So there are like many use cases for the user. So we will be like, from a single point, a lot of use cases are going to come, lot of actions are possible. So for that we need to use fork. Okay, so fork means that from a particular single point, multiple points are going to come, there are multiple actions possible. So just click on fork and just place it over here. So it's just a dark line, okay? So you can just make it big, and let's just connect our control flow from valid authentication valid. You can go and access whatever things you want. Okay, it's landing. It's fine. So that's good. So let me just scroll it down. It's going to go so big. So first thing, basically, let's just satisfy the needs. Okay, first thing is going to be your user is going to just search for a book in our library system. So it's going to be action is going to be search book. Okay, so he's going to just search the book, and he's then going to just view the book. Okay, view books. Be search books. Okay, so our next one is going to be add book to cart. He or she may can just order the book. Okay, it can be like an ebook or a book that is going to be home delivered. It can be either the way. Add a book to cart, and it's going to be edit our cart. Okay. Edit card or edit book. Okay, so this is what it's going to happen. And so once he or she has selected the required book, he or she is going to just make a payment, and it's just going to log out. Okay, so it's going to be payment, and let's have like a log out. Okay, so at the end everyone is going to log out. So let's have, so for log out, before log out we need to have like a point where multiple number of actions are going to meet. For that, it's going to be join. So join is also like quite similar to fork only, but same thing, only the name is changed. Okay, so it's just going to be here, and finally we will have our action logout. So don't worry, I will just write the other possible actions also. I'm just trying to complete the structure first and then go deep with the actions. So it's going to be logout and our final completion. Okay. Okay, so now we'll just put the control flow for this search books. Okay. Search books is going to be then from search books. If you want, like, you can even also add here search books, then book found. Yes. And you can yes means the user can view the book, add book to the cart, edit book. Suppose if the user searches a book and the book isn't available, you can just direct that user to the logout itself. Because what are the users going to do after he or she has sent found the necessary book? You can just make him log out. It will be like too complex over there. I just want to keep it simple. You can, what means you can add that feature also, the feature that if the user does not find the necessary book, okay, you can just add it. Just go over here and finally it's going to come. Okay, that's fine. That's one of our actions our user can do. And next one is going to be like user details. Okay, user details, and user details and update details. So details are maybe like mobile number, email, or any change in address if necessary, because the book is going to get delivered in your home. So you need to be really careful with address. So that's what is user details are going to be like. So it's going to be user details, and it's going to be update details. And once a user has just wanted to do that, user can just log out also after that. Okay, that's fine. And let's just extend this. Okay. Okay, that's fine. And next one is due date checking. Every library will have some particular months or days for the validation of the book. So once the due date is over, the user can like recharge by paying some amount of money, or he or she, if he wants to return the book, he can go and return the book. And suppose if he doesn't do the both, if he doesn't even return the book, doesn't refresh the due date, doesn't try to extend the date, it's going to go and end up in a penalty or a fine. So for that, it's also going to be due date check. Okay, due date check. and here she can return or update the date. Okay, so it's going to be return or update the book. Okay, update the status of the book. And this is going to be like the decision box. Okay, so if the user, like, if the user has if the user hasn't done both, it's going to be a fine. Okay, so it's going to be like pay fine. Okay, let's just have a text over here. If due date extended, if due date is extended, then the user should pay a fine. Okay, so let's just have a control flow. Okay, over here. Okay, one, and let's have another control flow from due date to return or bid book, and from our extended pay fine. And after paying fine, the user can just log out, or you can do the remaining other actions. Okay, that's fine. So let's have another text prediction. Yes. So you can also have a no thing and no thing, and just you can put that no to or log out also. Okay, that's unnecessary steps. So you want to avoid that. So after this, I think the this is more than enough. I guess, like, it's already so perfect. We have covered almost all the cases necessarily possible. What if you want? Like, you can also have order status. Okay, suppose you have ordered a book and you are yet to receive that book, you can also even check the order status as well. And I think this is like more than enough. Yes, just put one over here and just attach. I think that's really good. Be really careful, you want to avoid this overlapping like this. So showing one option. Okay, that's fine, I guess. And I think this is really good. So that's it. That's it for this video. And mine is a programming channel. Actually, I have run tutorials in C, C++, Python, Java, Blender, that is 3D animation, and Unity. Also, I have run many use case diagrams for many systems. So you can also check those videos in my channel. And it'll be really great if you could subscribe and support me. And thanks for watching.